neurosurgeons and doctors and everybody started coming to the room, and they said, oh, you have a mass on your brain, needs to come out. And they sort of said, do you want to see a picture of it? And they showed me a huge tumor that was looked like was like the quarter of my brain, so right on my speech center. So it was a little bit scary. And so then I said, can I call my husband? I said, I have a brain tumor. Can you come? I cried a lot. Yeah, I cried a lot. Mostly when my kids weren't around. So it was hard because I didn't want them to see me. I mean, I did cry with them. And they were sort of very confused. But when I like had big breakdowns, I would just do it with my mom or with my husband. And he had breakdowns and my mom had breakdowns. And it was just, you know, you cry a lot. And it, I think it's good. You know, you are scared. I think that's the first thing, is you're scared. And then, I know. You're scared and then... Then you get angry because, like, why me? Why all of this stuff that has to happen to a 33-year-old? And then I was either like, go home and cry, or be sort of proactive. And I had a friend that had the same kind of cancer as me, and she was diagnosed a year and a half, I think, before me. She said, I know you don't believe me, but you're going to be okay. Like, you're going to be able to accept it. That's what she said. You're going to be able to accept it. I said, no, I'm never going to be able to accept this. She said, I know you won't believe me, but you will. And I totally do. And I totally know what she meant. And I volunteer a lot. And I spend my time keeping busy because that's sort of my coping mechanism. I sort of keep myself as busy as I can without doing too much, because then I get sick, which I am right now, or I have a seizure, or I can't remember anything, or my brain just says, you're done, you're shutting off, goodbye. And that's happened a couple times.